somewhere in the Alps.
So, Agent Gracefully, you're part of our spy exchange program from Canada?
Try not to say my name too often. I'm trying to travel incognito.
Actually, you're traveling in the Alps. What do you have there?
I got something very important out of a smelly trash can.
Well, of course it's smelly if you got it out of a trash can. You need a hobby.
No, not smelly. Smelly! As in the society of meaningless evil, larceny, lying, and yelling.
Of course, our evil nemesis.
Spy Fox, you've got to get this trash bag to Spy Corps headquarters.
No, I've got a better idea. I'd better get this trash bag to Spy Corps headquarters.
Oh, and take this gadget from Professor Quack. You may need it.
What is it?
Dehydrated skis. Inside of this little pill is a pair of skis. All you have to do is add water.
And pray tell, why would I need a pair of skis? I came to get information, not recreation.
You may need them to get away from those bad guys. Good luck, Spy Fox.
Bad guys? Got water? I've got to get out of here. Although this would be a nice getaway cottage, I've got to get this bag to Spy Corps headquarters. Mobile Command Center.
Please stand by.
How's the mission going, Spy Fox?
I have a valuable clue which I'm trying to get to you.
What's keeping you? Don't tell me that you're trapped by some goons.
You guessed it.
Don't forget that you might have a gadget that may get you out of that jam.
Forget the jam. How about out of this ski shack?
Most definitely. Monkey Penny, out.
Fun! Oh, things from space. My favorite game.
Ow!
You got the high score. Water, work your magic. The dehydrated skis are now rehydrated. Feet, don't fail me now. Skis, I mean. Which way should I go? I wonder which way I should go. With my Olympic ski ability, I bet I can ski right past those goons. Which way should I go? Did you miss me, Chief?
So you've analyzed the trash bag, I see. And what have you found?
It's a model box 1/1000 scale for one evil robot. On the side, it says, "Some assembly required." Sounds like an excellent title for one of my adventures.
It has a mailing label that reads, "To La Roche, care of Chateau La Roche, World's Fair." Inside the box are assembly instructions. You'd better take these with you, Spy Fox.
Wow! You can learn a lot by reading.
If Smelly is involved, they must be up to their usual no-goodness. You'd best go check out this World's Fair. Monkey Penny and Quack have already set up the mobile command center.
I'm on my way, Chief.
Spy Fox, are you okay?
Shaken but not stirred, Monkey Penny.
So it looks like we're on to something big.
Yes, I think Smelly is up to some monkey business, Monkey Penny. And it looks like it's up to you, me, and Professor Quack to get to the bottom of it. Well, you and me anyway, Monkey Penny. I brought the assembly instructions I got out of the Smelly trash bag.
Well, of course it's Smelly if you got it out of a trash bag, Spy Fox.
No, Monkey Penny, not Smelly. Smelly, as in the Society for Meaningless Evil, Larceny, Lying, and Yelling.
Our evil nemesis.
Why don't you leave those assembly instructions here with me? Then you can refer to them whenever you're back here at the Mobile Command Center. And remember, you can contact me via your spy watch at any time.
Don't forget to check out the spy vending machine, Spy Fox. It's full of new gadgets for you to try out. I'm sure you'll find some of them quite useful.
Thanks. Now I need to go get busy and go give that La Roche at the Chateau La Roche a visit and find out just what he's up to. It's the assembly instructions for one evil dog bot made by Smelly Toy Division. The termite grenade. I'm sure this gadget isn't bug-free, Professor Quack. How does it work?
You've got to be careful with this one, Spy Fox. Toss it at something made of wood and get out of the way. It's good for one serious pulping.
That's not something you want laying around the house.
Not unless you're good friends with a carpenter. These blueprints are an acquired taste I haven't acquired yet.
An alarm deactivator. What in the world could this gadget be used for?
Well, it's used to turn off alarms. You attach one end to where the alarm signal is coming in, and then attach the other end to where the alarm signal is going out. The alarm signal is then redirected harmlessly into the alarm deactivator, keeping the alarm from going off.
It just looks like a wire with two alligator clips on either end.
Yes, it's beautiful in its simplicity, isn't it? I once printed these on exploding paper, but man, did those cause heartburn.
The fingerprint replicator utensil kit. How does this work, Professor Quack?
You'll eat this one up, Spy Fox. You place the fingerprint sending fork device on your target's plate. Then, when they pick it up to start eating, their fingerprint will show up on the fingerprint receiving spoon device.
This is hands down one of your best spy gadgets yet, Professor Quack.
I hope to follow it up with a matching salt and pepper shaker. Maybe if I mix these with a little goat's milk. Nah, let's not go there.
The Stealth Vac. How does it work?
You just hook up the handy nozzle, then press vacuum to suck up the particles into the handy travel bag. Or press reverse vac to blow the particles housed in the travel bag back out through the nozzle attachment. And it does it all in perfect silence.
Ingenious, Professor Quack.
I'd prefer those between two slices of bread, but when duty calls...
Spy heat. This looks like some hot work. How does this gadget work, Professor Quack?
Now, this gadget, I'm really proud of. You can spray it on something, say like a thermometer, and watch the temperature rise right before your eyes.
Now that's a gadget that really rises to the occasion.
You could say that again.
All right. Now that's a gadget that really rises to the occasion.
Light on the palate, rough on the tummy.
I bet these are cool. Spy skates, they look sharp, Professor Quack. How do they work?
I've always loved the grace and beauty of figure skating. But being in the spy biz never left time for the years of training. So I created these. You simply slip them on and insert a diagram of the skate maneuver you want to perform, and voila! The skates, with you in them, perform it perfectly.
Well, those could sure help to put the villains on ice.
Ah, right. Spy Fox. I like these new blueberry-flavored blueprints.
A spy key replicator can. What's the key to this gadget, Professor Quack?
That's a one-shot camera, like no other in the world. It's specifically made for replicating keys. You take a picture of the key you want to replicate, then bake it in an oven. The picture shrinks down and hardens into an exact duplicate of the key you took the picture of. It can only hold one picture at a time, but you can take a picture over another picture. If you bake a picture into the wrong key, just insert the key back into the camera and it will turn back into key film.
I'm sorry, what did you say?
Don't worry, it's a point and shoot easy bake gadget. It's a good thing I need my fiber.
That's the spy heat. Those are the spy skates. That's the spy key replicator can. That's the Stealth Vac.
Excuse me, sir.
What seems to be the problem?
Well, I hate to be the bearer of bad tidings, but unfortunately, I cannot allow you to enter through the service entrance. I'm sorry, but I can only let cashiers with proper ID in today. See? It has the job title of cashier and a matching photo.
I seem to have lost my ID. Can you let me in without one?
I feel your pain, sir. Really, I do. Unfortunately...
It seems that I'll have to find a way to get the proper ID. The entrance is closed and it's locked up tighter than an impervious steel door. A free photo booth, just one of the many joyous pleasures in life. Do you ever feel bored having the job of a service guard?
Oh, I hardly ever get bored.
Is there any chance that you can bend the rules just a little bit and let me through?
I'm sorry, sir, but I cannot. Unfortunately, I must request that you stop asking me to let you through without a proper cashier ID card.
Cashier. Tourist. Golfer. Waitress. Wrestler. Fisherman. Dishwasher. Jockey. Ballerina. Clown. Cashier. Arena. France. Dentist. Nun. I look ridiculous. This is a rather cool-looking device. What is it? One of those novelty gadgets that lets you see what you'll look like in 50 years?
It's an ID maker. Of my own creation, of course. It's for making identification cards.
Fascinating. How does it work?
You place a photo in the photo slot, choose an occupation and any name you like, then press the Process ID button. A completed ID will pop out of the machine.
Professor, you're amazing. What if I made an ID, but then I change my mind and want to make a different one?
Well, if you don't like the ID you created, you can make another card. Just reset the name and occupation, insert a new photo, then press the Process ID button again.
That sounds like fun. Creating false ID cards is something only secret agents can do, and then only when we're on a case.
Right!
Name. It says Nancy. Muriel. Carlton. Rudy. Nell. Chuck. Reginald. Maurice. Roscoe. Nancy. Muriel. Carlton. Rudy. Nell. Chuck. Reginald. Cashier. Helicopter pilot. Jockey. Dishwasher. Astronaut. Professional bowler. Waitress. Band leader. Ballerina. Journalist. Cashier. Excellent! The photo's in place. Professor Quack's machine works perfectly. My identification card is complete. I expect that this will come in quite handy. We'll be right back. Here you are, sir. One cashier ID card.
Oh, my. I'm so happy that you were able to find it. Let me guess. It was in your other pants, wasn't it?
Why? Yes, it was. You must be psychic. If you'll excuse me, I'm late for work and they need me in the restaurant.
Oh, I understand. I won't keep you any longer. I'll just keep your ID on file for you, Reginald.
Keep up the good work.
Have a spectacular day. And if I don't see you tomorrow...
Ah, Napoleon LaRoche. I should have known you'd taken up with the likes of Smelly.
So SpyCorps has sent the famous Spy Fox to try and stop my plans for world domination.
World domination? Of course.
Ah! Since you are one of the few people who could possibly understand my genius, I will explain my entire plan to you in nauseating detail. You see, I reversed the scale on the smelly evil dogbot assembly instructions. I've created a 1,000-to-1 scale, fully functioning evil dogbot.
Just where do you think you can hide such a monstrosity?
You silly spy. You're standing in it.
Of course, you've disguised the evil dogbot as the centerpiece for the World's Fair. Complete with a revolving restaurant.
One has to eat, no? Observe the means to my world domination. People buying tickets for the World's Fair do not realize that as they file through the turnstile, they are unwittingly winding the highly advanced clockwork mechanism within the evil dogbot. When the 1 millionth person has filed through, the dogbot, now wound to maximum capacity, will embark upon its horrifying rampage of destruction! Once I have unleashed the dogbot, all the world's leaders will sit up and beg for mercy! It is unstoppable! It cannot be called off because it has no off switch! Yes, I have removed the off switch and hidden it somewhere in the World's Fair, so cleverly, so subtly, that you will never find it!
That's what you think, LaRoche.
Even if you did find the off switch, you would still need the activation code to turn the switch off. And even if you had the off switch and the activation code, you could never hope to get past the diabolically clever security device located in the evil dogbot's Achilles heel, which is the only way into the dogbot's inner workings. It is hopeless, Monsieur Le Fox. There's no way you can beat me!
You'll never get away with this, LaRoche.
Oh, I think I will. And now, Monsieur Le Spy Fox, adieu!
Judging by those monstrous metallic molars, I've been imprisoned in the dogbot's mouth. How humiliating. I must find a way out of this cell so I can stop that evil roach. If I could only reach that fire escape through these teeth. I can gather information about LaRoche with this talk balloon. LaRoche's goons didn't follow the assembly instructions close enough. They seem to have left a few gears missing out of this contraption. I bet this loose gear is supposed to go somewhere. This gear is too small. I wonder where this gear goes. This gear is too big to go there. This gear is too small. This gear must go somewhere in here. I bet this loose gear is supposed to go somewhere. This gear is too big to go there. gear must go somewhere in here. That did the trick. Well, I guess it's like they say, the tooth shall set you free. Talk about escaping by the skin of your teeth. Now to stop La Roach and his evil plans for world domination. My spy watch is beeping. I'd better answer it.
Please stand by.
Spy Fox, Agent Walter Wireless has intercepted a microfish message from Dottie Dash.
Where's it coming from?
It sounds like it's coming from an exhibit called We World.
We World, eh? Sounds silly.
The message is staticky, and Walter Wireless needs to get closer to hear it. You can pick him up here at the Mobile Command Center.
By the way, I've recorded Napoleon LaRoche's evil plans, and I'm sending them to you via the spy watch.
I look forward to hearing the dish. Monkey Penny, out.
That bad guy put on those glasses, breathed on that breath device, and the secret door opened. That must be the secret door La Roach mentioned that leads to the inner workings of the evil dogbot. I need to figure out how to get in there. These rose-tinted glasses might come in handy. I can't see what that evil person ate. I need to be higher up to look over that bad guy's shoulder. I don't want to get a headache wearing these rose-colored glasses all over the fair. What's this? It looks like a pair of binoculars. Whatever that thing is, it's letting that bad guy type with the glasses on into the evil dogbot's Achilles heel. It looks like some kind of breath analyzer. There's too much of a rose tint on that screen to make out what breath it's showing. Ah, these glasses really add a rosy glow to the whole fair. Groovy. I can see that goon breathing into the analyzer. Something's appearing on screen. It looks like Onion D. White. That breath analyzer is checking for the aroma of Onion D. White. I just need to eat some Onion Delight and breathe into that breath analyzer, and then I'll be able to get in that evil dogbot. I can use this talk balloon to gather information about the breath analyzer food Onion Delight. Something seems fishy. Cod, bear your soul.
Oh, I'm sadder than an ant in a neck brace at a picnic. In the old days, it never failed. The Cape Cod would razzle and dazzle with his mighty cape of joy, and then the finale. A shot out of the cannon.
Sounds exciting.
Then, one fateful day, we were at a sea monkey convention, and my assistants Goldie and Blow were setting up my act. My lucky clear goggles were misplaced, and in their stead was a pair of dark goggles.
So what you're saying is that you need your lucky clear goggles?
You ever try to steer yourself with dark goggles after you've been shot out of a cannon, son?
Not lately, no.
Well, it's impossible to see the target.
How about lending me your dark goggles?
Since I don't have my lucky clear goggles, I need something to wear for my act. Even though these ones are so dark, I keep missing the target.
Is this Plant World?
Correct, my dear. I am Madam Ladybug, the slightly irritated owner of Plant World. Instead of the beauteous red rose I ordered, I have been sent a mutant Venus flytrap by Napoleon LaRoche.
Nice cage, though.
A locked cage for which I have no combination. On top of it all, this particular Venus flytrap has something in its mouth.
Interesting. It's the off switch. How diabolical of a roach to feed it to a mutant Venus flytrap. I've got to get it out of there and find a rose for the ladybug. No small feat. I can use this talk balloon to gather information about getting a rose for Madam Ladybug.
Sir, you have a stamp on your hand?
No, I can't say that I do.
I better stamp your hand so you can get back into the fair. There you are, sir. Have a nice day.
Thank you.
Spy Fox, I've been waiting for you. Smelly is up to their usual bag of dirty tricks, I see.
Walter Wireless, Spy Corps' top tracking bug. Good to be working with you again, Walt.
You too, Spy Fox. The last time I ended up with a fever from being cat scratched.
Right. Sorry about that. So, you picked up a microfish message from Dotty Dash.
That's right, but all I could make out was something regarding an off-switch activation code before the signal went dead. I've got to find Dotty Dash, Spy Fox. This must be important. The signal was traced to an exhibit in the fair called Wee World.
Wee World, eh? Sounds like your kind of place. Well, hop aboard, Walter, and I'll get you into this Wee World.
I'm in there like swimwear.
Heh, that's my line. You must be the guard who defends this place.
That's classified information, laddie. How did you find that out?
You're dressed as a guard and you're defensive.
Hey, hands off those keys. Those keys are to all the exhibits at the fair. No one can touch them but me.
It says one. I wonder which key I should take a picture of. Key one.
Go right in, Reginald.
kitchen with Dinah. Blip, blip, blip. Stir, stir, stir. Blip, blip, blip. Stir, stir, stir.
That won't do me any good.
Blip, blip, blip.
Can you prepare onion delight?
Why, I won the French Cooking Medal of Honor for my onion delight. Well, of course I can make it. Well, that is, I could make it. But I only have one onion right now.
Can't you make it with the one onion you do have?
Absolutely not. The good onion delight must be made with exactly two onions. Here, you can take this one, and if you can find another exactly like it, I'd be more than happy to make you some onion delight.
Thanks, Chef. Two onions, eh? I'll get those for you on the double.
Comes in the kitchen with Dinah.
May I use your oven, please?
Sorry? The insurance regulations strictly prohibit the use of this oven by anyone other than a trained chef. You don't look anything like a chef.
I'd better answer my spy watch.
Please stand by.
Spy Fox, an informant has a hot tip about the off switch and is waiting for you at the Food of the Future exhibit. Ask for the candy apple.
The candy apple. Got it, thanks.
Monkey Penny signing off.
Spy Fox out. So that's my contact, eh? Brilliant disguise. I'd like a candied apple, please.
Certainly, sir. Here at Food of the Future, all food is on sticks. It allows you to enjoy your favorite foods without using a knife or fork or having to stop what you're doing. Here you go, a free candied apple on a stick sample.
Well, I have the candied apple.
Isn't that just grand?
Yes, but I, meaning me, have in my possession the candied apple.
Only one candied apple sample per customer. Now run along and enjoy the fair, Pumpkin.
Maybe she wants me to come back when there are less people around. Oh well, this candied apple looks good.
Watch what you're doing. You want to give me a coronary?
Ah, Lenny, you're the apple of my eye. What information do you have for me?
Hi, Spy Fox, listen close. There are spies everywhere, so don't look directly at me. This leaf contains the information that you need.
This is too small to read.
What do you want from me? I wrote it with my teeth. Now I got the split. People are starting to stare. Throw me in the dumpster.
Suit yourself.
Oh! I'm all right. Save yourself.
It says food cloning.
Welcome to You Clone It, where you get two for the price of one. Bah.
Stereo sheep.
I'm Doll, and I'm Lee.
Hello, Dolly. So nice to have you back where you belong. I have this onion.
Don't come running to us with your troubles. I think he wants us to clone it, Doll. Very well, Lee. You do the honors. No. After you, I insist. No, please. After you.
I'll do it.
Don't touch that.
Isn't that amazing?
Yes, but does it do Julianne Frogs?
You can always tell what a customer's not going to buy, Lee. You speak the truth, doll.
The nice ladybug would really like a rose. Do you think I could have one of yours to give her?
I'm sorry, but I can only give out a rose when an ice skater performs a perfect triple greasy axel.
I can gather information about the triple greasy axel ice skating move with this talk balloon.
Go right in, Reginald.
Someone's in the kitchen with Dinah.
Here you are, two big juicy onions.
Wonderful! How exciting that you should find two so identical. They appear to be exactly alike.
Perhaps they're related.
The secret to gourmet cooking is careful mixing of only the finest ingredients.
Hopefully, we'll have the opportunity to try that one of these days.
Voila! Oh, thank you!
My breath should now be potent enough to get me past that electronic sniffer and into the secret workings of the giant robot dog.
Someone's in the kitchen with Dinah.
Maybe I should contact Monkey Penny on the Spy Watch and see if she has any ideas how to stop this evil roach. Here's where I keep my Wouldn't you like to take a walk to stretch your legs?
Yeah, but I have to stay here to keep an eye on the thermometer. If it goes over 80 degrees, I have to go phone the air conditioning repair guy.
80 degrees, hmm?
Hey, you! You cannot go in! The Wax Museum is not open yet!
Would you believe me if I told you that I had my own television show on public access called Entering the Wax Museum?
Yes, but you may not go in. And don't stand in front of that thermometer. I have to keep a close eye on it.
Just watch this spy heat the joint up with a demo of his spy heat. Excuse me, but the temperature has gone up well over 80 degrees.
place. Oh dear, I'll be on hold for hours.
That spy heat certainly was the hot ticket. Ah, St. Joan of Arc. She made sure that every child in the world had access to ice cream. She became the patron saint of cold cows. Thomas Elephant, inventor of the mesh umbrella, light bulbs painted black, and shoes made out of bubblegum, gum shoes. After playing in them all day, you could have a stinky snack. George Washington Cougar, an inventor who found 101 uses for gelatin. Gelatin sneakers, gelatin tires, and gelatin bricks. They don't last, but the inventions look cute when they wiggle. Bella a Bug, who worked hard for roaches' rights. She worked hard for better housing for roaches who wanted to escape those deadly hotels. Bert Barracuda, a successful songwriter who wrote such pop standards as Do You Know the Way to Swim Upstream? And my personal favorite, What's It All About, Algae? Wolfgang Duck, an innovative chef known for his imaginative pairings of fresh local ingredients with his own version of what's tasty today. I like to cook, and I'm an imaginative fox. A chef outfit just might come in handy. That's not going to do me any good with this problem.
Go right in, Reginald.
Someone's in the kitchen with Dinah.
Ahem.
Oh, excuse me, I didn't see you come in, Chef Wolfgang. What a pleasant surprise.
Well, I was in the neighborhood and I thought to myself, my, it has been a long time since I last prepared food inside a giant mechanical dog.
Yes, well, of course, as a fellow master chef, you are welcome to make use of my kitchen.
That's very generous of you. I believe I...
But you may not use my wooden spoons. The purple ones, they are mine and I need them.
Of course, how foolish of me.
You know, of course, that too many master chefs spoil the broth.
Chef Dinah, I can honestly say that compared to you, I am merely an imposter.
Oh, Wolfgang. You are such a kidder. You are too kind, too kind.
Stir, stir, stir.
I have to admit that at first I thought Professor Quack's idea for a spy camera was half-baked, but it turns out to be pretty hot stuff. I'll leave my chef outfit here, just in case I need it later. I'm not done using that yet, so I need to hang on to it. Well, That's the alarm deactivator. That won't do me any good. What do you know about the triple greasy axle ice skating move?
You look tense. Let me give you a massage. I tell you, kiddo, I did the triple greasy axle as the masked she-bear. In fact, that skating move is fully illustrated in the latest edition of the bi-monthly magazine Skaters Weekly in a color diagram and everything.
Color diagram? May I have that?
It's all yours, sweetie.
Thanks. That's not going to do me any good. That's not going to do me any good. Here's where I keep... That won't do me any good. Here's where I keep my... Now I'm set to show off the moves I've learned in the Spy Ice Follies. That ice is very slippery. This should do the trick. I was so good, I burned the skates out. Oh well, I don't need them anymore.
You did it, kid!
I haven't seen a move like that since Sonya Henpeck!
Thank you. What a perfect red rose.
Where do you think you're going?
That exhibit is closed.
It's all right. I have a key.
Oh, well. If you've got a key, then go right in.
Ah, the right key. Excellent. See, I told you I had a key. This opening is too small to get through. It'll take someone much smaller than myself to get through. There you go, Walter. You've got to find Dottie Dash, the microfish.
You can count on me, Spy Fox. I'm real close to finding Dottie Dash, the microfish.
We can come back later to look for Dottie Dash. Here's where I keep my spy gadgets.
This car is my ticket to the dream house. This is the only way to travel. This just in, design flaw discovered in Dream House. What a shocking waste of valuable attic space. Well now, things are starting to look up. Down is only half of the elevator's job. I've been told that it's impolite to stare, but in this case, I'll make an exception. This button operates the elevator. That refrigerator is in the way. The refrigerator is now in cold storage. This button opened that door. My instinct tells me I'm getting closer to Dottie Dash's location. I can open and close the top drawer with this button, but will it sort my socks? This button opens and closes the bottom drawer. Typically, I would open and close the drawer by hand. And the $74 million question is, who invented the retractable TV? Calm, cool thinking pays off. Film at 11. Around and around and down, this is Walter Wireless. Eureka.
Walter, I'm glad you found me. I've been on surveillance here in WeWorld, searching the airwaves for anything suspicious. I intercepted a smelly message that has to do with some activation code. My equipment went on a fritz before I could get the whole message to you in Spy Corps, but I think it's really important.
I'm sure it is, but if it was a radio message, how do you know it smelled bad?
Not smelly, smelly. The Society for Meaningless Evil, Larceny, Lying, and Yelling.
All right. Our evil nemesis. So what was the rest of the message? I need to transmit it to Spy Fox right away.
Of course. The activation code is cherry, pineapple, orange.
Got it. Walter Wireless calling Spy Fox.
Please stand by.
Come in, Spy Fox.
I read you loud and clear, Walter. Did you find Dottie Dash?
I did. I'm going to transmit the activation code Dottie intercepted to you via the Spy Watch. Stay tuned.
Cherry, pineapple, orange. I've got it, Walt. Good job, Dottie.
Thanks, Spy Fox. The rest is up to you now.
Good luck, Spy Fox. This is Walter Wireless, signing off.
I've got the off-switch activation code. Now that LaRoach is in for it.
Over 12 hours to ride the ride, famous French pastries of the past. A cream-filled adventure. It was the highlight of the fair. The attendant refused to let me on because I was not tall enough to go through the turnstile. brother, Tolaki, it laughed at me. I thought that one day it would be I who would do the laughing.
Ha ha!
I am laughing.
Ha ha!
See, it is I who is laughing. Yes. Very soon the evil dogbot will be fully wound. And without the off switch there will be no way for anyone to stop me from crushing all the turnstiles and conquering the world!
Madame, would this rose be suitable?
I thank you. Now, if I could only open that display cage, I would replace that mutant flytrap with this beautiful rose. Sadly, however, I was not given the combination.
I see.
But you can still have the flytrap.
Houdini, I'm not. I'll have to find the combination to that locked display cage. It's the off code for the evil dogbot. Cherry, pineapple, orange.
Ah, rapture and joy. I have my rose. Now, what about the flytrap?
We should get it out of that cage.
If only we had the combination, then this moment would be perfect.
That and some pancakes. It's some kind of combination lock for this display cage. That's the locked door which leads into the dogbot's inner workings. I've got to crack the code to get inside. What do you know about that? Onion Delight did the trick. Now I can come and go as I please. Roach's breath analyzer was no match for a clever international spy like me. I must be in the belly of Roach's evil beast. I should have a look around.
Look at them. The fools are unaware that by simply entering the fair, they are making possible my plans for world domination. As they enter the fair, they pass through a turnstile, which rotates a series of gears beneath the admissions gate. These gears, in turn, rotate a giant underground thread screw that passes below the fair to the base of my cleverly disguised giant robot dog. From there, another series of gears turn, spinning the drive shaft, which turn, yet more gears that wind up the massive spring that will power my unstoppable, evil dogbot. When the 1,000,000th tourist comes through the turnstile, my evil dogbot will be completely wound. And then, I will unleash the dogbot on the unsuspecting world and conquer it in the name of Smelly! Ha ha ha! Holy roach, that is a good one.
The opening and closing of that door must be controlled by some sort of fingerprint recognition device. I wonder what would happen if... A picture of LaRoche. I'll bet if I want to get into that room, I'll have to find a way to get a copy of LaRoche's fingerprint. those mutant Venus flytraps sure have a taste for flies. I guess that's why they're called flytraps. I'm blinded by the light. I need something to shield my eyes. What can I do to get those goggles? That welder turns his back on the goggles every time something comes down the conveyor belt. I wonder if I can get him to stay at the conveyor belt longer so I can get those goggles. That makes the conveyor belt go faster. I have the goggles. I believe these are yours, Capes Cod.
My lucky goggles! I can't believe my eyes! Ugh, everything sure smells a lot different with these on.
You mean, looks a lot different, don't you?
No, smells a lot different. Where'd you find these?
Sorry, they've been in my pocket for a while. Can I borrow your dark goggles, Caped Cod?
Heck, son, you can have them. I don't need them anymore. Best not to use them for flying out of a cannon, though.
Thanks, that's good to know. Do you happen to know anything about La Roach?
I know he enjoys a good botanical exhibit now and then. I know I do. All those lovely plants and the beautiful smell. That Plant World exhibit is prettier than a red wagon going up a hill.
I'll keep that in mind. That won't do me any good. That's the Spy Gadget vending machine. That's the fingerprint replicator utensil kit. Warm me up on how the spy heat works again, That's the Spy Gadget Vending Machine. That's the Termite Grenade.
Go right in, Reginald.
Oh, gracious me. Oh, my, oh, dear, oh, dear, oh.
Excuse me, what's the matter?
I don't have a single fork for Mr. LaRoach's dinner, and he gets so surly when he has to wait for his food.
Well, you know the old saying, surly to bed and surly to rise. Ah, that's LaRoach's dinner?
Yes, spit-roasted boot béarnaise.
Don't tell me. The sauce isn't...
Oh, yes, it is.
Ugh. I think I'm going to be sick.
Now, where are all those forks?
Here you are. It so happens I carry a fork for just this kind of situation.
A fork? I've been looking all over for one.
I learned in boot camp it pays to have a fork at all times.
Thank you! I'd better get this spit-roasted boot béarnaise out to Napoleon the Roach before he starts acting like a heel!
It's only a matter of time now before I have LaRoach's prince.
Spit-roasted boot béarnaise, my favorite dish.
This boot was made for eating.
And that's just what I'll do.
Pretty soon that boot is going to be inside of you.
There it is. Now I'm almost ready to give LaRoach the boot. And I don't mean for dinner.
A little tough, but still good.
Someone's in the kitchen with China. Stir, stir, stir.
That won't do me any good. UV rating 750. These should show me the light in a good way. The light is bright, but this spy is brighter. It's a room full of Venus flytraps. They're under a big bulb. I wonder what LaRoach is up to. There must be a million flies in there. When that jar opens to feed those fly traps, they must really open wide. This must be the place where LaRoach got that fly trap he delivered to Platworld. So this is where that fiend LaRoach gets his fly traps from. I've never seen so many flies before in my entire spy life. Those fly traps must really open wide when that jar opens to feed them. It's a room full of Venus flytraps. I wonder if they're related to the one I saw in Plant World. Let's give this a try, shall we? Like the old song says, a spoonful of LaRoche's fingerprint helps the steel door go down. It's the off code for the evil dog bot. Cherry, pineapple, orange. That must be where I need to set the off switch activation code. Grape. Cherry. That must be the on switch for the evil dog bot. That's where the off switch goes. The flytrap is locked in this display cage by this rather interesting lock. It's the leaf from Lenny the Informant. That's not going to do me any good. A magnifying glass.
Yes, I use it to get close up on the leaves and petals of all my lovely plants.
I can see a star, a circle, and a triangle on this leaf. I've opened harder locks than this. With the right combination, this would be a cinch. I did it!
Oh, thank you, sir. I'll just replace that atrocious flytrap with his beauteous rose.
Nicely done. I can dispose of that flytrap for you.
How polite. Obviously, you're a fox with home training.
Yes, I am housebroken, thank you. That looks just like the perfect place to set this mutant Venus flytrap. This must be the place where La Roach got that flytrap he delivered to Platworld. That mutant Venus flytrap prefers to eat flies instead of off switches for giant evil dog bots. I have the off switch. La Roach's evil scheme is crumbling.
Soon my diabolical plan will reach its fiendish fruition. I will be unstoppable. For who or what can possibly stand up to the onslaught of a big giant mechanical dog robot? My sophisticated machine of menace will march across the surface of the earth and claim it in my name. People will shout my name to the skies. La Roach! La Roach! La Roach! And I will say, yes, what is it? All the world leaders will sit up and beg for mercy. It's quite an evil plan, no?
I'll bet my Uncle Chico's piano keys that that is where the off switch must go. At last, the off switch is in its place and the activation code is set correctly.
Finally, the 1 millionth customer has come to the turnstile. The dog bot is now fully operational. Let's hit it!
I don't think this is a good sign. I hope La Roach has earthquake insurance. Must get to the off switch. Bad dog bot. Sit.
What? Spy Fox!
You called? La Roach, your evil days are over.
I don't think so. Sun has not yet set.
I should go in after it. That La Roach won't get away from me. I wonder what he's up to now.
That Spy Fox thinks he's so smart. I have one more trick to play before I make my escape through these sewer pipes. This computer program will set up a million toasters hidden in the dog park. Together, the toasters will simultaneously burn a million pieces of toast, leaving a dark gray cloud hanging over the fair for the next 10 months, much like Seattle. Oh no! There's a bug in the program! Ah! I must check my variables and track down all the stray pixels!
That dastardly LaRoach won't get away with that. Not with Spy Fox on his trail. I'll see that LaRoach gets a nice suite at the Spy Jail Hotel. I bet that wrench could come in handy. I have to break through that glass to get it. Ouch! I have to find something other than my shoulder to break that glass with. That pipe looks like it's connected to the pipe directly below LaRoach's getaway cart. This ball peen hammer looks interesting. It might come in handy. I've got it! There, that moved the sewer grate out of the way. Interesting. When that lever is thrown, LaRoach's escape cart will plummet down the track. I'm sure that's part of LaRoach's escape plan. I'll need to change that plan. That made the sewer pipe move. I don't want to do that just yet. I already moved the grate. I think that... I'm sure that pipe is connected to the pipe directly below La Roach. It's down the drain for you, La Roach.
What? You again?
Uh-oh. How humiliating.
For doing such a commendable job in catching Napoleon LaRoche Spy Fox, you get my eternal gratitude.
I had excellent help on this case, Chief.
Ah, yes. I present to you the Grand Golden Family-Approved Fortified Supreme Certificate of Excellence.
Thanks, Chief. It was all in the line of duty.
Who's beyond reproach? Gizmos and gadgets galore.
When the bad guys come to call on him, you know he'll even the score.
When times are uncertain and mischief's afoot and baddies are moving about,
the fox in the tux.
For the deductive reasoning and daring deeds displayed in disabling the dangerous and destructive evil Dogbot, for saving the World's Fair from the total devastation, and for defeating the deceptively dastardly and decidedly deceitful villain Napoleon LaRoche, you are hereby awarded this Certificate of Accomplishment along with Spy Corps' highest honors and unyielding gratitude. Signed by the Spy Corps' Chief and stamped with the Spy Corps' Wax Seal of Excellence.